knows about that day.
It's a battle of the books, Bible versus Quran. And the Quran is winning. Almost every day on Nairobi's streets, Muslim clerics and Christian pastors compete for converts. The crowd follows every word. The lead cleric claims several converts a day.
Every day, five, six. Kila siku tunaslimisha watano.
Sometimes he adds as many as 10 or more a day. This 23-year-old nursing student is one of them. After 18 months of soul-searching, he changed his name from Duncan Mogoi to Saad Omar Nasser and became a Muslim last month.
In church, there are no perfect answers, as in for Islam, because I feel Islam is complete. Everything you'll want to know, or every query you'll have, automatically you get an answer, direct.
His conversion came in the same month as Al-Qaeda allied Al-Shabaab, radical Islamists who'd been recruiting heavily in Kenya, were attacking Nairobi's Westgate Mall, killing 67 people. There are no nationally publicized government figures here for the number of conversions. And in the aftermath of the Westgate Mall attack, that shift has some people here concerned.
Then it's about finishing the mob.
Robert Ochler works for a charity combating extremism in neighborhoods where he says converts are on the increase and radicals prey on their innocence.
They're being taken over by these young radicals, you know, who take them in and then distort the whole religion. They influence their minds. They tell them this religion is about fighting.
Members of Ochler's group are the only independent de-radicalizers in Nairobi. Stopping Al-Shabaab recruiting here, he says, is a constant battle. But the group's US funding runs out year's end, and they're already shutting down their outreach. He fears the Al-Shabaab radicalizers will get a free hand with the converts.
Once the funding is cut off, who is going to counter what they're saying? You know, just the government sending security forces there every now and then won't help solve the problem.
For recent converts, Saad, those extremist radicalizers are a real danger.
Do you feel safe from that?
Not 100%.
Why not?
Because I don't know the influence they can have. Because you can't tell this one is an extremist, this one is not an extremist. So you just mingle with them in prayer, in the mosque, you can't tell. But yeah, it's a concern.
In Kenya's overcrowded, mostly moderate mosques, new converts have never been so vulnerable. Nick Robertson, CNN, Nairobi, Kenya.